Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss how companies use flexible budgets for performance evaluation. We'll start off with a brief discussion on what budgeting is and how it can be used to measure performance using variance analysis techniques. Next, we'll discuss the difference between static and flexible budgets and look at an example of how these tools can be used to make better business decisions. Understanding how to use flexible budgets effectively can significantly improve a company's performance evaluation. So let's get started. Imagine you set up a goal for yourself to exercise 5 days per week for the upcoming year. You start off well for the first few months, but then you get injured, making it impossible to keep up with your goal. Given that something outside of your control changed from when you originally created that goal, would it be useful to continue to compare yourself to that same goal for the rest of that year? Probably not. It would be more beneficial to make an adjustment to that goal based on the new circumstances and use that as motivation to improve throughout the remainder of the year. When circumstances change for a company, they can use this same approach by working with flexible budgets, using them to more accurately measure the organization's performance. Companies go through a process like this when they're preparing budgets by spending time putting together these budgets, such as operating, financial, and production budgets. Budgets are not limited to just these alone. However, these are examples of the most common categories of budgets. These types of budgets not only allow the organization to plan for the future, but also allow them to set goals and track the company's performance. Regardless of the size of the business, budgets can provide a significant benefit to the financial result of an organization. So let's get started. Now, budgets are plans that detail a company's financial goals for the future. They help companies determine the required actions necessary to meet their objectives. There's two key elements of the budgeting process consisting of budgetary planning and budgetary control. Budgetary planning consists of a company's ability to look ahead into the future. This includes coming up with specific strategic long-term and short-term objectives for the organization, as well as developing financial projections. Budgetary control, on the other hand, consists of looking backwards to see if a company's actual results were in line with their planned expectations. To do this, companies create performance reports using either static or flexible budgets. Comparing actual results to the budget can help an organization pinpoint things that went well and take corrective action towards improving things in the future. For example, if they find that they spent significantly more than expected on raw materials 1 month, they may want to look into using different materials or purchasing a more affordable supplier going forward. As we mentioned earlier, performance reports can be completed by a company using two approaches, static and flexible. The first is a static budget performance report, which compares actual costs with the budgeted costs for the budgeted level of activity. Static budgets are created in advance based on an expected level of activity and do not change throughout the year. That's why they're called static. Companies usually create what's called a master budget, which takes into account their expectation for sales and spending for the upcoming year. Once the year is underway, the company would continue to compare their actual results to this original master budget each period for that entire year. Now, while this can be effective in certain circumstances, if there's major changes in sales volume, production volume, or the economy, it may no longer be useful to use that original master budget to monitor performance. We'll look at a specific example of this shortly. To address this issue, companies can use flexible budgets. Flexible budgets can be used in performance reports by comparing actual costs with budgeted costs for the actual level of activity. This means instead of comparing the actual results to the static budget that was created before the year even started, the company can use an updated budget based on the actual level of activity as a comparison tool. This helps managers understanding what their costs should have been for the actual level of activity. For example, if a company planned to produce 1,000 units of a product, however, they ended up producing 2,000 units based on an increased demand, it's likely they would have spent more than they originally planned on things like material and labor because their production doubled. As a result, it wouldn't be fair to measure their performance based on that original production plan of only 1,000 units. Now, it's a common misconception that static budgets are a good benchmark for preparing a company's performance report. While this may be true when a company's output is very similar to what they originally planned, in reality, this is usually not the case. It's very common for business environments to change throughout the year, resulting in a company's output to fluctuate significantly from their original expectations. When this happens, their costs typically vary substantially from their original static budget. As a result, comparing the planned costs for one level of output to their actual costs at another level of output doesn't provide the business with good information to be able to accurately measure performance. Let's look at an example of how using a flexible budget when evaluating performance can be much more useful than a static budget. In this example, a company planned to produce 5,000 units for the month of January, but they actually ended up producing 8,000 units. To get an understanding of how well they managed their spending on materials, let's first look at a portion of their performance report using a static budget. As you can see, based on a budget of 5,000 units, the company planned to spend $100,000 on materials. However, since they actually produced 8,000 units, they actually spent $155,000 on their materials, resulting in a $55,000 unfavorable variance. This performance report and the result is therefore saying that the company spent $55,000 more than they should have in this period. However, we would have expected the company to spend more on materials, since they produced more units that period than they originally planned. It's entirely possible that the market demand went up, requiring them to produce 8,000 units instead of 5,000, which could have led them to spending much more money on materials. As a result, it may not be fair to measure their performance against that original static budget. Let's see how things change if the company were to use a flexible budget approach for this same scenario. Here we can see that the actual column stays the same. However, in this case, the budget is updated based on the actual units produced. Here we can see that instead of comparing the actual results to the original budget of 5,000 units like we did before, we're now using the actual 8,000 units produced to create a new flexible budget. We calculate this new flexible budget number in two steps. Step one is to calculate the budgeted expense per unit from the original static budget. In this case, the company originally planned to spend $100,000 based on a production level of 5,000 units. By dividing $100,000 by 5,000 units, this works out to a budget of $20 per unit. In step two, we would take this budgeted $20 per unit and multiply it by the 8,000 units that were actually produced. This tells us that based on the actual production level of 8,000 units, the company should have spent $160,000, which is our new flexible budget number that you can see in the chart. Now we're comparing apples to apples instead of apples to oranges. At a production level of 8,000 units, the company should have spent $160,000. However, they actually spent $155,000, resulting in a favorable variance of $5,000. If you look back at the previous example, a company using the static budget approach would have reported an unfavorable variance of $55,000. However, now, using the flexible budget approach, we can see the company has managed their costs well and has actually spent $5,000 less than they planned. This is a much more effective way to measure the performance of this department. And that brings us to the end of this video. Remember, in order for organizations to be successful in the long run, they need an effective way to monitor the company's performance. Flexible budgets are an extremely useful tool that give companies the ability to do this effectively. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.